There are no easy missions left for NASA anymore.
These are difficult and expensive things to build.
The mission that we're doing, there's no precedent to follow here.
These are compelling reasons to do this. They can't be done with the existing data, and they will advance our understanding of science significantly.
This is the question. What will I know for sure after this mission is over that I do not know today?
NASA headquarters issues these calls for proposal, calls for ideas for missions. Titan mission would be probably one of the most exciting missions in the history of NASA.
Titan represents the explorer's utopia.
For a brief period of time, this is like the most habitable place in the outer solar system.
If you think about it, there's only four places in the solar system that have a solid surface and an atmosphere. Earth is one of them, Venus is a hellhole, and we're doing Mars really well. Titan is as interesting as Mars, I think.
We're gonna have the opportunity to look for the signs of life and the signs of habitability.
And right now we are in the process of designing the mission.
We're trying to decide what this mission will look like. Is it gonna be a boat, submarine? Is it gonna be just the orbiter? What is the most exciting and affordable mission?
The question is, can we sell the science? And I think we can.
It needs to be about the science and the compellingness of the science, which has nothing to do with whether it's a flyby or an orbiter.
There is a competition. There are other teams that compete with you.
The boat on the surface of an extraterrestrial lake, that's the thing that grabs people. That's really exciting.
To float on an alien sea, I mean, that would be amazing.
Don't ever, ever in this proposal imply that something is easy.
Proposals are very demanding.
Operation between heat shield and that's why we
can. Writing and putting together this proposal can be really overwhelming.
So the things that we do are expensive and there's very long time scales involved and there's so many things that can go wrong.
There's a lot at stake there. If something goes wrong, boy, that's a tough one to take.
Cost risk is the issue, not the risk.
To have a successful proposal, you need experts in many different areas.
So now you can see this is the whole trajectory, right?
I'm the lead mission designer. I do Google Maps in space, and I figure out the car. When can we launch, when can we reach there, and how much mass we can get there, and how long it'll take.
And then the heat shield gets dropped off, which is the curved part.
I'm an entry, descent, and landing engineer. I'm responsible for the probe that's splashing down in a Titan sea. We're trying to predict weather on another planet 20 years out, so.
We're doing things that are so far out. We have to be creative. It's a very creative team.
This is a design that I've been working on for about 8 years now. This is a map of the solar system, cylindrically projected, of the planets and their major satellites at the time of my birth.
If you work on space exploration, you have to be an optimist.
Where do we stand right now? Is there a possibility?
You have to feel that you are going to win. You have to feel you have a mission that is worth $1 billion for NASA to spend to send the spacecraft there. Any mission that we would want to do can be achieved. Within budget is another question.
How much is the budget you have? When you come out and say, wait, we are way over the cap.
At this moment, do we have a probe, or we have $100 million problem, or what do we have?
Well, the cost is the primary factor that I'm worried about.
At this point in the mission, cost is our big question mark. Right now, we're trying to do a lot.
There's been a lot of uncertainty, and there's been a lot of churn.
I'm sharing with you my deepest fears.
And okay. I appreciate that. The lander is great. The orbiter is great. We need both.
We're worried we might be over budget. We might have to cut the probe. And no one wants to cut the probe because it is awesome, okay?
Now is when exciting decisions are made.
Whether or not we can actually fly the sea capsule. And if we have to remove it, it's going to be a heartbreaking decision for everybody.
When you get to these very difficult decisions, what do you do?
I agree that you don't get the mission you want, you get the mission that you can afford.
I don't think we can afford the probe.
If there's no Titan mission because of the probe, then we drop the probe.
I almost have tears in my eyes, really. It's, you know, we did the best we can, and now we have to succumb to reality. And the reality is we can't afford to probe.
If you want to be within the cost cap comfortably, yeah, it's the only choice. But if you want to take a risk, and
I don't think we even have a choice.
Not all is lost. The team has done a lot of work on the sea probe.
So that's why I wanted to say,
set it aside. Yeah. And build the best, most attractive Titan orbiting mission that you guys would propose.
That was heartbreaking. I mean, really, yeah, this was a very, very difficult decision.
But we have to just not be emotional about it and just cut it off.
Now, of course, when we cut the probe, we also opened up our budget. Orbiter scientists got excited because now we were able to truly spend more money on the mass spectrometer on the orbiter. We could get an excellent infrared camera.
Winning teams make decisions like this.
I am a visual strategist. For this proposal in particular, it's storytelling, branding, logo design. If you want to show entry, landing, descent, then let's just show it all in one image. Our first concept was as soon as the probe was scratched, we decided to kind of zoom out a little bit and stay away from anything that would imply that we're going into the water. Depending on what you want them to feel at the end, it might be a good idea to have an inspirational thing.
Yeah.
The Titan story of habitability, which is a good slogan, or maybe you want to say Oceanus tells Titan's story of habitability. So what do we mean by organics factory?
Well, it means, you know, organics are being built. We start with very simple methane, and then
if you add up all the sections that are in the proposal, this adds up to about 250 pages when it's done. This is a big deal. This is a $1 billion proposal. This has to be clear.
Nothing counts unless you can communicate it to other people.
Yeah.
And secondly, and it can be career limiting if you cannot communicate well.
Martin Luther King Jr. was giving his speech. He said, "I have a dream." He didn't say, "I have a plan." So giving people something that pulls at their heartstrings is much more effective in getting them to emotionally invest.
And you look at everybody who is in this room right now, everybody here was critical.
Everybody is a consummate professional here. But also everybody is a human being that invested everything that they have into this Titan mission.
You cannot be part of a proposal like this without being all in.
We're talking about 15, maybe 20 years of mission.
You have to realize that maybe this will define the rest of your professional life.
You ready to submit?
Yes, you have to click on this one here, just to make sure.
The proposal ends with our director pressing a button, and it goes to NASA headquarters.
Here we go.
Yep.
That's the final keystroke.
You know, it would be a tragedy if we put all of this hard work and that would not be also a good experience. But it was one of the better experiences in my life.
I work at NASA for 37 years and I've been on 15 missions. And winning the Titan proposal would be one of the happiest moments of my life.
To know whether we are alone in the universe, you know, you can put that in the big picture.
We have a lot of stories for years to come about things that happen while writing the proposal.
It's more than just writing a proposal. It's a team effort. It's I think it's a human adventure just to write the proposal.